Hi dear students, in this video I am going to discuss about therapeutic nursing care. So in this chapter, as a nurse, how she is going to give the care for the unconscious patient. So this is the subject of fundamental of nursing and for GNM first year. So we will see how the nurse is going to give care for unconscious patient. So we have seen in previous class, for unconscious patient, how they are going to treat that patient in emergency care. So how they are going to give that emergency care in unconsciousness. So that thing we have seen in previous. So now I am going to explain about long-term care in unconscious patient. So whereas comfort in emergency care, how they were giving care in emergency. So whereas comfort long-term. So for unconsciousness patient, long-term care, how the nurse is going to provide. That thing now I will explain. First thing is, in order to optimize the care of the unconsciousness of the patient in a hospital, it will be helpful to know the cause of the unconsciousness. So first thing is, when the patient is become unconsciousness, so better that if the cause, exact cause, the nurse knows that because of this cause the patient became unconsciousness. So if they know about that cause which led that unconsciousness, if they knows that cause, so that they can provide, you know, they can provide, you know, optimize the care of the, so they can provide proper care. So depend on the cause, they can provide the care. So it is nothing but in order to optimize the care of unconsciousness. So in order to optimize the care of unconsciousness, they are identifying the cause. So if the cause will help to the nurse to, in order to optimize the care, so of the unconsciousness. So it is nothing but in order to optimize the care of unconscious patient in a hospital, it will be helpful to the, it will be helpful to know the cause of the unconsciousness. So to how they have to know that cause, so due to which this cause the patient became unconsciousness. So how the nurse has to know that thing, the which cause lead this unconsciousness. So this is, it involves usual steps. So that is involves to know the, to identify that cause, it involves the usual steps that are the history taking by collecting history collection, past history collection, present history collection of the patient. And next thing is, there are assessment process also is there by palpation, by inspection. And the next thing is auscultation. These all these things are involving in history collection. So to identify the cause and examination of the patients, and next investigation. So when the patient become unconsciousness, so depend on the cause, so they are going to see this, all those things. So to identify that cause, they are going to collect history collection. Next thing is, they are examining the patient. And next thing is, they are seeing the investigation. So these things are the usual steps to identify the cause of unconsciousness. So next thing is, general care is however necessary, no matter the cause of. So for the general care, however, it is necessary, but no matter of the cause, and no matter the cause of general care is however necessary, no matter the cause of conscious. So is important the, so it is important to determining the extent of care required, and may involve doctor and nurses, physiologists, nutritionists. So for this unconscious patient, when they are going to treat this condition, when they are going to give the care for unconsciousness patient, so who all are involving for this unconsciousness patient? Involved by doctors, nurses, physiotherapists, nutritionists. So these all members are involved. So for the unconscious patient, so especially the nurse is going to give the care, and whereas the physiotherapist is giving physio. So he is providing physio. So by giving this physio, the patient become activity. And next thing, we ask him for nutritionist. So the nutritionist, she will tell so which type of diet the patient has to take and which food contain high protein diet. So depend on the cause, depend on the diagnosis. So some diagnosis leads to the unconsciousness. So we have seen in previous what are the causes as leads to the unconsciousness. So depend on that cause, depend on diagnosis, the nutritionist, they will tell the diet. So which diet is involves. So high protein diet, and next thing is high calorie. So depend on that, the nurse has to provide. And next thing, this physiotherapist, nutritionist, doctors and nurses, these all members are involved in the unconscious patient. So we have seen in first thing is, in order to optimize the care, that is better to know the cause of the patient. So to know that cause, how they are going to identify, how they are going to confirm which type of cause, by collecting history and by doing examination and by seeing investigation. So, but here general care is however necessary no matter the cause of conscious. So it is important to determine the evaluate care of required. So whatever the cause, whatever the thing, but for unconscious patient, so these members are involved. So these people are involving for giving the care for in unconscious patient. So these things we have seen in long-term care. So these things are general. So completed this thing. So next we will see position. So as a nurse, how she has to keep the patient position. So why she has to maintain the patient positions and what is the purpose. So if the patient is unconsciousness, so patient is in unconsciousness. So unconscious patient cannot mobilize himself. He cannot turn, he cannot do any activities. So such type of patient, the patient is completely bedridden. So such type of patients, if the position is not maintaining properly, there is a chance to get pressure ulcer. So in order to prevent that thing, in order to prevent pressure ulcer, bed sores, that thing, the nurse has to maintain proper position. So how the patient in the lateral or sits position. So for unconscious patients, they cannot keep supine position. So because they cannot keep supine position. So they have to keep in lateral position or sits position or sometimes supine position. So next thing is, an unconscious patient has a of unconsciousness. So whereas some for position, the patient position should be in lateral or sits position. And next thing is, they never keep the patient head in supine position. So because of this supine position, whatever the vomit and secretions, these things if the patient is getting, there is a chance to aspirate in the lungs. So in order to prevent that aspiration in the lungs, they have to maintain the proper position of the patient, and they should keep the patient position in lateral or sits position. And next we will see airway. So how they have to provide the airway such type of patient. So unconscious patient cannot tell anything so about the air. So if the patient is having oxygen levels, if the patient is having difficulty in breathing pattern, so about those things the patient cannot tell himself. So in order to identify those things and to maintain the proper airway, as a nurse she should observe the patient condition. So yeah, whereas come for airway and adequate airway. So adequate airway should be maintained at all times. So you know, to prevent whatever the patient is having difficulty in breathing, so to prevent that thing, the nurse has to provide adequate airway. So adequate airway to be maintained at all times for what? To provide good oxygen levels in the body. And next thing is, frequent section may be required. So we have seen in unconscious patient, there is a chance to get secretions, and next thing is vomiting. So the patient cannot tell and the patient cannot vomit out. So that things the nurse has to observe. So to provide that good airway, whatever the airway obstruction, so in the when to provide good airway, whatever the obstructions are present in the pharynx, so in order to prevent that things, the nurse has to provide, she should do the frequent suction. The nurse has to do, because to provide good airway, so whatever the obstructions are present in the pharynx, that things the nurse has to remove the all the secretions by doing suction. So if she has to observe the patient condition, if it is frequently occurring the suction, if it is coming frequently, the nurse has to give the frequent suction to give provide good airway to the patient. So that is the airway. And next we will see observation and charting. So whereas come for observation and charting, here by name itself you can understand that is observation of the charting. So here as a nurse she has to observe the level of consciousness of the patient. So in previous we have seen that is how they are going to assess the level of consciousness, that is known as, so that is called as a GCS, Glasgow Coma Scale. Through that scale, the nurse can assess the level of consciousness of the unconscious patient. So they have to assess the level of consciousness here in observation. And next thing is the size of pupils and it is reaction to light. So they have to see in the eye whether the pupils are reaction to light or not. So the size of pupils. So that thing they have to observe in the observation. And next thing is observation is required every half an hourly. So here level of consciousness and about the size of pupil and it is reaction, whether it is reaction to light or not. So these observations should be done every half an hourly. So to identify the abnormality of the patient. So whether the patient is maintaining it properly or not, whether the pupils are incorrect or not. So that thing they have to observe. So whether the patient conscious levels are improving or not. So that thing they have to observe and they should maintain one chart to write those things. So whether how is patient conscious level and however the pupils reaction. So that thing to maintain those things they have to maintain one chart and they should write in that chart. And next thing is not only these things, and temperature, pulse, respiration, oxygen, blood pressure. So these things they have to maintain. The patient is having severe head injury. So such type of patient they have to maintain it every hourly. What is the temperature and how the pulse rate is and how the respiration rate. And next thing is how about blood pressure. So these things they have to maintain every hourly and they should maintain the chart. So everything they have to write it in a chart. How is the patient vitals and every hourly. If it is required every hourly and if it is not required also every second hourly for unconscious patient. So depend on the patient condition they have to observe very hourly or second hourly or fourth hourly. And this is must and should. And next thing is intake output. So not only these things, they have to do urine analysis also. So mostly if the patient is having renal failure, if the patient is having diabetic mellitus, so such type of patient, so how much amount of urine they are passing. So if the patient is unconsciousness, the patient doesn't know that when the patient is passing the urine. So that thing they have to observe. So how much ml of the urine they are passing. So that thing they have to identify and they should maintain for that one chart and they should write it in that chart. So especially for renal failure and diabetic mellitus, so such type of condition the nurse has to observe very specially. And next thing is they have to maintain IVO chart also. And next thing is the appearance of muscular spasm is recorded and note the area affected and the duration of the fit. So there is a muscular spasm. So if the patient is having muscular spasm, so when it is affected, so which area is affected, so that thing they have to note it in the paper. And next thing is not not only that, they have to see the duration of the weeks also. This thing also they have to observe. So these are the things we have seen in observation and charting. So for long term care in unconsciousness patient, so how they are going to give the care? The patient is unconsciousness. So such type of patient, because of which diagnosis, because of the which cause, they leads to the unconsciousness. To identify that, the nurse has to collect the history collection. And next thing is, when the patient is unconsciousness, the patient cannot tell the history collection history. So from the relatives, from the family members, they have to collect the history collection. And by seeing that, by doing examination, by seeing investigations, these things they can identify the cause of unconsciousness. And next thing is, they have to see that. So for this unconscious patient, for giving the care, so they are involving doctors, physicians, physiotherapists. Next thing is staff nurses, and next thing is nutritionist. So this all are members required for this unconscious patient. So when they are going to provide care, so from physiotherapist, he is going to provide physio, and whereas come for nutritionist, she is going to she is going to educate about diet, which type of diet the patient has to take. Next thing is, whereas come for nurse, she has to administer the medication and she should take care of the patient. So these are those things are involving in unconscious patient. So whereas come for position, as a nurse, how she has to maintain the patient position. So to prevent aspiration in the lungs. And next thing is airway. So to provide proper airway, so how the nurse has to provide the care of the patient. And next thing is observation and charting. So how they have to observe and what things they have to observe especially. So that thing now we have seen. So completed this topic. Next we will see hygiene.